Blessed love family, great news from the Priest Isaac's Institute of Holistic Knowledge. We are now enrolling new students for our ongoing international homeschool program. Yes, family, now is the time to contact us to get more information on our African heritage classes as well as our astronomy classes. Let me explain. Our classes are factually and scientifically based, plus designed and prepared for the inquisitive yet tender mind of the child. Classes are sent out daily via the email and will appear in your inbox every Monday to Thursday. Your young ones will receive over 140 classes in a 10-month period. That's an academic year. Interactive, colorful. Your children will love it, and you will be happy that you made that investment in them. But listen to this. We have a very special offer for you, family. This 10-month homeschool program usually goes for $50 per month. But for a limited time, you will pay only $30 per month. And hear this, not three, but $200 for the full academic year if you decide to take the full year package. This is a worthy investment in your young ones. To enroll today, email us at priestisaacinstitute@gmail.com or visit the website priestisaacinstitute.com for more information. Also, feel free to ask us for a sample, a free sample of our classes. Once again, priestisaacinstitute@gmail.com. We're looking forward to hearing from you. Blessed love.
Yes, family, blessed love. Give thanks to the life giver and the keeper of life, Emperor Haile Selassie I. And even at this moment, we definitely celebrate life and celebrate love as we celebrate and glorify the 91st anniversary of the coronation of Negusenagas, of the coronation of the King of Kings. And even at such time, we reminisce on the 91st Psalm, you know. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly. No, that's the first psalm. You know, the 91st psalm is what? He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Yeah, so we definitely give thanks, you know, for the coronation of the King of Kings. Give thanks for the coronation of the Empress. For those who do not know, we are talking about on the 2nd of November, 1930, in Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, fulfilling such prophecy and history and so many different things. And, you know, we intend to do a program on that, directly dealing with, you know, the prophecies of the coming of Negusenagas, the coming of the King of Kings. But I just want to touch upon for the moment here a very important subject, directly dealing with the issue of Haile Selassie putting his foot on the bomb. And that is a picture. I will bring it up in a moment that we all have seen. And there's some stories behind of that. And I said, let me just, you know, address it. We have never addressed it directly. And we said, we'll put it on the table and, you know, put it on the table in its factual sense. So before we go further, of course, you just heard the ad referring to the international homeschool classes. Give thanks for all of you who have already reached out to us, at least just to, you know, get some more information and to get a sample of the classes so you could see for yourself what it is you and the young ones would receive. Those who have not reached out to us as yet, and listen, you don't have to have children. I mean, the knowledge and the information that you will be getting on a scholarly level, I'm talking about with the international homeschool classes. You could be 35, 45, 55, or 65. Email us, priestisaacinstitute@gmail.com, and we will guide you through. But really, what's on the mind right now, it's just a few days from now. We're talking about the 3rd of November, family. I know that you are ready and prepared, as I've asked you, my family. If it is one time, your brother is going to come to you and ask for you a favor, family. What's the favor? I just want you to be there. I would like you to be there every day, but Wednesday, the 3rd of November. Remember, this is Patrons Day, the first ever Patrons Day. This is going to be an annual event. We're doing this the 3rd of November every year. It got to be a Sabbath or something that we do it the day after. But the 3rd of November is the coronation anniversary of Menelik II of Ethiopia. The day after the coronation anniversary of Emperor Haile Selassie I. Very mystic. And this is our official day for Patrons Day and Webathon. And it is also, this first one will be the official launch of the Priest Isaacs Institute of Holistic Knowledge website and Radio Anu International. So everything will be taking place on Radio Anu International for the whole day. So from 6 a.m. in the morning, I'm talking about Eastern Caribbean time. I think it should still be Eastern Standard Time as far as the back and forth clock in the United States, from 6 a.m. till midnight. And I would love you to be there early, family, to be there at 6 a.m., even prior to 6 a.m. Naya Bingi all through the night, going on to the morning uprising. And of course, we're uprising with devotion and prayer and then go straight throughout the day. We have many guest speakers and lecturers and wonderful ones that will be coming in. I already gave you a highlight. The Honorable Prophet Aija Starr will be with us. The Honorable Empress India, Chef India, will be also coming and launching her book, her vegan book, her food preparation book. We have Brother Akeem Pierre that will be with us. Of course, the Honorable Empress Naya will be with us, going into the depths of the yoga and the doula tradition. We have Honorable Prophet Ras Drake. He will be with us representing Rastafari Experience Antigua, and a host of other ones, family, and special surprises, and so many things will be happening on that day. So all I want you to do is to be there. And I'm looking for a squad of ones, a sharing squad, a squad that will share the link throughout the day. I mean, listen, man, this is Patreon's Day. This is the day when all of our products and services will have a special offer attached to every one of them. So even if it's just $10 that you spend with us that day and patronize, or even for the Teleton Webathon, even if it's just $10 for that day, we'll be very thankful for that. This is a once a year thing, because remember, no matter what you buy, you're going to get in return much more than that is worth. And in a few hours, maybe I'll be uploading a video giving you details, for those of you who are interested in exactly what the special offers are for the 3rd of November, which is Wednesday, the 3rd of November, 2021. And remember, this is an annual thing. Every year we'll be doing this. So we'll have specials on our books, on our documentaries, our courses, our classes. You heard us just speak about the international homeschool. There'll be a special offer attached to that. So many things that, as I said, once you come into the hall and you patronize, you're going to leave with much more than you really bargained for. That is the truth. So it's a day of giving back, you know, a day of showing love. And even if, for whatever reason, you cannot patronize, well, at least share the link. You know, and I say for whatever reason, because to be very honest, man, especially if you are a fan, if you are a follower, if you are an admirer, you know, if you really desire or respect the work, especially if it has touched you, especially if it has moved you, some of you even say it saved your life. Well, to be honest, man, if we have a Patron's Day and you can at least put $10 into it, and I'm not even asking you to give us. We're not begging for it, even just to say, well, let me buy the book, which is worth 20, but I'm getting it for 10, and I might get the next one free. You know, I mean, to be very honest, that's actually your responsibility. No, let's be straight. If you can talk all of that, and you know to your heart that you respect what you see us do, and you appreciate it to the point that it has touched you, and maybe saved you in one way or the other to the point that you can say it with your mouth and you can say, well, yeah, man, this is good stuff. Well, to be very honest, in the spirit of brother and sisterhood and harmony and supporting Black business and the freedom to speak, my brothers and sisters, I'm being very clear, even to spend a 10, a 20, a 100, 200, I mean, we have many different products here. Your shopping list can go into the thousands for what we have here to offer, from yoga to doula services to homeschool classes to courses on archaeoastronomy to courses on theology and so many different things, and subscriptions to radio programs, plus many different things, videos, books, documentaries, you name it, shirts, mugs, different, you know, chalices, and can go on and on and on. So you can go and take some money out of the bank, yo. In fact, you don't have to take it out of the bank, because we use Cash App, we use PayPal. You're done now. I'm very serious. We use Zelle, you know, we use Squarespace, we use something else. Yeah, we use them. So just contact us, of course, you know, and we'll give you all the information. So this is serious stuff, my family. You know, give thanks for your patient listening and understanding how important this is. And I needed to be there. The least you can do is to be there, family, so I can see you, because I can see you when you're there. And I know that you're right there. And I could appreciate and appreciate love that, yeah, you're there. You know, South Africa is in the house. Zimbabwe is in the house. You know, Peru is in the house. The whole globe lighting up because everybody is in the house. You know, partaking of the first ever Patron's Day and Webathon. Keep in mind, as I said, the mission that we are on and the responsibility that has been given to us, family. In reality, we must have our own platform. And you must appreciate the man. To be straight, you must appreciate your brethren. Don't come, and I'm not comparing myself to nobody, but almost everybody I watch, they're begging you to just something in the Cash App. Come on, just something in the Cash App, donate and whatever. I mean, yeah, that might be a byword from us, but you know, because most of you say it, you know, our forefront is business, barter and trade, yeah, commerce. Industry, yeah, we promote it and we encourage it too. We encourage it. You cannot survive in this world unless you have a mentality like that, a business mentality. Just the mentality starts there, you know. And to be honest, I am honored that I even inspire some to get a business mind and business mentality, because ones have told me that they're very inspired on the way that I'm persistent when it comes to encouraging Black business and even supporting Black business. You know, we have programs where we invite people to come and sit and speak about their business. There's nothing we charge for that, you know? And even some of us, we still shy in that. We should not be ashamed or afraid. Business. Yeah, man, Black business too, so we should support. So I'm looking for you to be with us, you know? To be honest, I'm more than looking for you to be with us, and I'm more than looking for you to share, and I'm more than looking for you to come and spend $10. I'm looking for you to support the works that you've been watching for such time. Straight up, 3rd of November, eh? Make sure you're there early and bright. All right, this is what we're going to talk about now. Here's my chalice. What I'm going to do right now, I'm going to present to you this is a program that was done. Some of you would have heard it. This is with Brother Muta Baruka and Brother Miguel Lawn, lawyer Miguel Lawn. And this is the video when they were talking about the cable and wireless situation with the Emperor and cable and wireless. But this part of it, they go into the situation with the bomb and the king and his foot on the bomb. Now, the reason why I'm pulling this out is because when we first came into this faith, and even up to now, many ones have had and still have a very, I would say, fanciful outlook of what this picture is all about. The main story is how we got it first. You even hear reggae people sing it and so that Mussolini was dropping some bombs. And they have a bomb that they drop on in the palace ground. Somehow this bomb reaching the palace ground. And the king go and step on the bomb and the bomb could not explode. Mm-hmm. Now, as the years went by and we studied and we read, and so I think the first place I came across a different version of that story was in the same book by Harold G. Marcus, The Formative Years. If I'm not mistaken, it's The Formative Years. But it's a Harold G. Marcus book, though. And he was speaking of that same incident of, you know, what happened. And it was bombs that dropped that did not explode, that the emperor actually asked to pile together. And in piling together, he, you know, took a picture. If you look good, it's more than just one bomb there. But anyway, I'm going to make the brothers speak about it, and then we can go into it a little more as we celebrate the coronation of the emperor.
Right. At the Berlin Conference, yes, in 1888, when the European powers, Germany got Namibia,
England,
Tanzania,
Belgium,
France, yeah, England, Belgium, a little country like Belgium, got, yeah, the Congo,
yeah,
Spain, Portugal,
yes,
Spain got Western Sahara and, yes, and so on. Portugal got Mozambique.
Germany get this Cameroon.
Right, and up by Rwanda and that made it up. So the guys, they meet at the Berlin Conference and cheer up Africa.
Mm-hmm.
So Italy now, as a fresh foot to this thing, I know, was vexed.
Yes.
So we never had a play.
We never get nothing.
We don't get nothing. So all along they had that ambition, mm, that not only do we come late, but we want the prize.
Yes.
And the prize is Ethiopia. Yeah. That was because Ethiopia and Libya were never captured.
Yes.
So they wanted the prize now. They said, well, we jumped to the head of the ladder.
Yeah.
Plus the Pope, who must overstand history now, we know that the head of the Catholic Church,
yes, Pope Pius,
definitely he wanted the number one prize, mm, because it would have boiled down now to a religious war.
Yes.
That the red, white, and blue has now captured the red, gold, and green. Mm. There was, mm, the papacy of, because I don't know if a lot of one know that the actual head of the Ethiopian church is called a pope, too, you know.
Of course.
Yes.
The Abuna is a pope.
It's called a pope. Pope, yeah. It's a title.
Ethiopian pope.
Definitely. Yeah. And it's an African title.
Yeah.
Yes. Mm. So they wanted now that they should have the supremacy in the papacy. Mm. And consequently, the pope, all of these missions were blessed by the pope. Mm. Physically.
Well, I have seen,
yes,
pictures. Moving pictures with the Pope standing up over the bombs and blessing them in the square of in the Roman square.
Oh yes,
yeah, the pictures of the Popes. I think it's Pope Pius.
Yes, the 11th.
Pope Pius the 11th.
Yes,
yeah
man.
He was blessing the, you know, today in them find some papers from him where eating out against Hitler and Mussolini.
Okay.
Yeah, them find some letters in the Vatican that Pope Pius XI was eating out against Mussolini and Hitler. But I have seen pictures.
Yes.
With him blessing the bombs them.
Yes.
Blessing the ammunition them for go off in Ethiopia for bomb the people them.
And this was why now, when His Majesty went on the field and him put him foot on the bomb.
Yes.
And called the photographers now.
To show them now.
So yes. Him put him hand and bless it and I and I trample it on the field.
Yes.
So we have to understand symbolism is vital here, you know.
Yeah. Him want to show the man himself. Yeah. Them claims say them never did use these kind of bombs, you know.
Yes.
And him show them all the serial number them on the bomb.
Yes.
This unexplode bomb. Him show them say, look here, take my picture.
Yes.
Make sure the whole world said them are go against the laws where them to set up like how Israel now cluster bomb up the whole name they know them find 1,000 cluster bomb dropping in a
Lebanon. In a Lebanon.
Yes. Which was an illegal thing.
Which is you know
and is America give them it.
Yes.
Yeah.
And also you know National Geographic, the photographer who took that photograph wrote an article on it, you know, how can take it, you know.
Yeah.
Because him said, when the Majesty went up to the bomb, you know, come remember, this is a real bomb, you know.
Yeah.
So the entourage that was walking with him, stop.
Yes, yes.
So when him called them now, most photographers never want to come. This photographer now, remember them days there, you know, where you set up this cloth business,
and
you put your head out of it, you go, pop.
Yeah.
Him say, I'm going to put your head out of it.
I might be about this time, yeah.
So him set up the camera still, you know. And then him run back. So he never knew how the picture was going to come out. You know?
Yes.
It's later on, and him said, picture come out. Good, no, him said, boy, I don't even know what to say.
And the unexploded bomb.
Definitely. Mm. So that's very, very important. That invasion now, which they use different pretexts, but the root of it was to take revenge for Adowa and also to get a piece of Africa.
Yeah.
Now, but the big.
You check it. All right.
I want all listeners to know that we're not diverting from the highest.
No, we're not diverting from it.
But the build up towards the case was this. In 1926, Italy and England met.
Mm-hmm.
And they agreed that they are going to Italy going to build a railway through Ethiopia. And Britain is going to take control of most of Lake Tisana.
Mm-hmm.
That's it. These are two countries met, don't consult the people of Ethiopia and make plans to divide up Ethiopia, you know, 1926. So when their majesty here now and bring it to the League of Nations, he said, imagine that, eh?
Yeah.
Two powers meet and decide how
my land go.
Divide up.
Mm.
So that gets exposed and embarrassment and all of that. This is 1926, you know. All right. Later on now, when their majesty was in exile in England, you had two brothers. And I want our listeners never to forget this, what we call the Hoare-Lavelle Pact. Samuel Hoare was the foreign minister for England.
Mm-hmm.
And Walter Lavelle was the prime minister of France. Now, them two guys are meeting, you know, and agree, sign agreement, everything, that them going to secede a substantial part of Ethiopia to Mussolini.
Mm-hmm.
As a way of appeasing him and cool him down, you know, that him can cool down for some of him exploits
treads,
in Europe.
Treads, yeah, him treads.
Right.
Yeah.
So they meet now, the Hoare-Lavelle Pact, and decided that they are going to give more than 3/4 of Ethiopia
to Mussolini.
To Mussolini, and leave His Majesty with about a quarter and a little piece of Ethiopia.
Mm.
Again, when Your Majesty here, Your Majesty come out and say, wait, what kind of thing that, what high class disrespect? So I want our listeners to understand, you say Britain is a treacherous country, you know. It pretend. Mm-hmm. You understand? It always underhand and all them weird.
Yeah, we can't see that in the slavery. In the
yes.
We can't see how they move the slavery thing. And,
yes.
You know, them
so right through. Because.
Yeah. Definitely give thanks to the life giver and the keeper of life and Brian Celeste the first. And again, that was a wonderful sit down, you know. Basically, the reason was really about cable and wireless and Haile Selassie first. And as he was saying there, he didn't want his audience to believe that he was straying away. But he definitely went into some different alleyways as such. But very, very good information. Now, again, that little piece of nugget, we're not trying to prove anything or convince you or trying to, you know, we're just putting it now to the public, to me, on a more you know, realistic way historically. So there's no need to add any flair to it. We don't need no pepper nor no salt, you know what I mean? We just, the truth is just the truth. But to me now, this is why I always say, you don't need to add anything, you know, to the emperor, you know, try to make it look more dynamic, you know what I mean? The emperor turned into a lion. I mean, if that happened, it happened. You know what I mean? I don't dismiss the truth neither. But if that is not the case, we don't have to go too far. But what I'm saying now, what has happened here, family, without the razzle-dazzle, that is a serious thing. All you have to do is understand the scene. You heard what the brother said a while ago. When they were approaching the bomb, not because the bombs dropped and they didn't explode when they dropped, mean they don't still have the ability to explode. It is not a bomber, it is several bombs. In fact, according to the book that I was speaking of early, they said that the emperor asked for them to pile the bombs up. As Brother Lawn said, Brother Nick Miguel Lawn said, when they were approaching the bombs, the entourage stopped. I could imagine everybody just, like, where we going, you know? You know, the emperor have to ask them what's going on. Because remember, I gave a situation a few days ago. I'm sure you could remember with the emperor in Sudan, when they were going over back to Ethiopia because of the attempted coup in 1960. And after meeting with some key personnel and a few ones of importance and getting things in order, the emperor was ready to return to Ethiopia in the dead of night. And the two engine plane had a problem with one of the engines, and the pilot was telling the king, well, you don't know, don't worry, we just take a bunker out and, you know what I mean, drink some hot cocoa, and in the morning, you know what I mean, the mechanic will come and drop his screwdriver and his wrench in there, and we'll be off by midday. And the king said, what are you talking about? Whose life are you in fear of, yours or mine? No, this is not, no offense, eh? I don't want it to sound the wrong way, but this is not Rastaman saying this or Rastaman's story, you know. This is documented facts. The king want to know, whose life are you in fear of, yourself or mine? And the plane, the make it, man, the plane made it where it had to go, you know. And it's a similar vibes here. Is the emperor you're waiting on, man? So the emperor moving towards the bomb. And according to Mr. Law and Brother Law and there, the entourage, now I don't know how many people in the entourage, or if it was just the foreign media, etc. Because it was the National Geographic photographer that was brave enough to get close to the bomb to take the picture. Apparently everybody else said, nah, man, I ain't not going to bother with that one anymore. We gonna miss this one here. You understand? And as he was saying, again, just to understand the vibes and how serious the situation was, he was highlighting that in those days, it was a case when you had the flash camera. If you never see it, at least in the movies or in the cartoons, you see it. When you light it and you put the flash on the gunpowder or whatever it is, and it poof, and it gives the brightness, and then you take the picture. So it was saying now that the photographer, of course, he's a professional in this, so he knows what's going on. And explosives. So by the time before the thing say poof, he already halfway across the field. Before the thing say poof, he done gone to the point that he didn't even know how the picture came out. So that alone is to show you, you know, that alone is to show you the powers, you know, thereof. Because look, okay, watch it good. This is the picture. So the camera looking here. Watch this brother here. Watch the young prince with the king. Even where the king looking, even this elder here. I get the impression that is the cameraman running away. I get the impression the cameraman running away. Just while the thing say poof, the cameraman running away. And then, you know, everybody at the same moment looking up at him running with Wingate. Running away. Run the man running away. Look at that. He's running away. Hey, what's going on here? He's running away. Yeah, well, that's the impression because they're looking in that direction because that's the history, you know. When this picture was taken, at the moment it was flashing, the photographer that was taking the picture was running away. And that is to show you how dangerous the scene was. So it still applies to the scripture that says, no weapon that's formed against me shall prosper, said the Most High. All them guns and bombs, as King Emmanuel said, Britain, biggest battleship cannot help her, even in this last judgment. So any which way you put this, this is a Superman, superhero kind of act here to go and step on them bombs, you know, with no fear whatsoever, not even in the touch of it. You can see the emperor didn't even think twice to do this. It's just like pancakes, really. Straight up. With maple syrup. Yeah. Where's the photographer? Where they gone? Hey. Yes, I will Emmanuelize. Lassie, I Rastafari. So it's always a joy, to be honest, to celebrate the emperor. That's why we're here. You know, everything we do is to get the word out. One way or the other, to let the word be known. That is the mission that was given to the disciples of Christ by Christ, to go and spread the gospel for Four Winds Universal. That is the mandate of all followers of Christ, not the special ones, not the gifted ones, not the chosen ones and those that have the talent and those who don't have nothing to do and have the time and all of that. No. Everyone, from you say you are a believer, you're, and I'm purposely using these terms, your duty, your main duty more than anything else is to make sure that the gospel of Christ is spread Four Winds Universal. That's what it says in the scripture, you know. So when you comprehend that and you consider that, you know, that's a very important thing. It didn't say planting marijuana. It didn't say whatever else, cooking item either. The main mission is to make sure that the word of God, that testifies of God, yeah, that testifies of God and that clarifies the presence of God, goes forward with universal. So even if you're not doing it specifically, and you can honestly in your heart say, yes, I see it being done, well then when you become a part of it, when you patronize it, and when you support it, then you as well become a part of the link that is actually spreading the word and the gospel Four Winds Universal. And that's basically what it is, eh? So me personally, I take pride in saying Emperor Haile Selassie I, trust me, pride. And I'm honored, believe me, beyond what anyone can even comprehend. I am honored that I'm even given the responsibility to do what you see I do and much more that doesn't even meet the eye. Yeah, to be able to call the king name and to come any moment, any time, and speak of him in many different ways, whether it's up in the stars or it's down on earth, the emperor is to be praised inside, outside, birds and bees, yeah, plants and trees, yeah, the tree of life, the green god, the Al-Qaeda, yeah, the Lord Pakal, any which way, the Asar, yeah, the Hercules, the Atlas. It is Haile Selassie I, inside, outside, any which way, Bible, Quran, yeah, whatever, mask of ancient kings, yeah, whatever it is, what we call a book there, and the purple hull, yeah, Krishna, Vishnu, bring it all, the cell, the molecule, the black hole, bring everything you got, it must ring the name of Haile Selassie, because he's the foundation of it all. Holy Emmanuel, Selassie, Rastafari. Give thanks, family, for your presence with us. And we're coming again with something spicy before the coronation is done. So you know what to do. Make sure that your notification is on it. Make sure that your notification is on so you hear the ding-a-ling-a-ling or whatever it says, really, you know, when we bring things to you. So we're coming again with another spice. All I'm telling you is make sure that you're there with us on the 3rd of November. Make it a date, my family, and don't be late. The 3rd of November, Radio Anode Patriots Day in Webathon, talking about the official launch of the Institute's website and, of course, the official launch of Radio Anode International. Of course, give thanks, life giver and the keeper of life. Heart of celebration, heart of coronation. Holy Emmanuel, Selassie, Rastafari, blessed love. Give thanks.